Hello and welcome to yet another Divi tutorial by the Divi Engine team. You know me, this is Roby, and today we're going to be spicing up our tutorial on adding custom posts to Divi by introducing the Advanced Custom Fields plugin to manage the various fields we used and that we'll need for our custom recipe post type. Now, if you haven't checked out that video yet, what are you still doing here? Go now, go check it out. But no, just kidding, don't worry. You do not need to watch that to follow along with this video. It'll just help to give you a little bit of a background on custom post types and why we use them in Divi. But anyway, that's enough of me. Why don't we go and get right into it? Okay, guys, so last week we left off by creating this recipes post type in our Divi install. When we click on all recipes, we'll see that our beefcake's still in there. And if we click into that, we'll see that all the info and all the time to cook and all that stuff is in there. But what we're gonna be changing today is this custom fields. And there's a wonderful plugin that is extremely useful. You won't believe that it's free, called Advanced Custom Fields, that can manage all these groups of fields that you need for different types of post types. And it comes with a bunch of different settings that we'll touch on lightly in this video. Now, Advanced Custom Fields does have a pro version that extends the functionality a bit, but just the base version is extremely helpful. So why don't we look at how we install that into our Divi install. Okay, so as always, we're gonna be starting out here in our Divi dashboard. Now we're gonna go to plugins and then we'll click on add new. And then what we'll do is we're gonna type in advanced custom fields. Hit that enter button. And it is gonna be this one with a green icon. There are a lot of extensions for it available on the WordPress repository, but we want the one by Delicious Brains. So let's go and install that. Okay, great. With that installed, you wanna make sure that you go ahead and activate the plugin. And there you go, we can see that it's activated. And on the left-hand column here, in your settings, you'll see custom fields being added. There is a menu item, so stick with me. We're gonna get into that right now. Okay, so let's quickly, with advanced custom fields installed, go take a look at recipes and go into that beefcake setting or entry that we have. I'm gonna scroll down, but you see here where it used to have all the different advanced custom field settings, poof, it's gone. It's missing, it's not there anymore. But don't worry, let's take a look at advanced custom fields by clicking the custom fields link, and then we're left here with the field groups. Now think of fields as just a collection of different fields that will go with your different custom post types. Now for a recipe, maybe you'll have a group of ingredients, or maybe you'll have a group of additional metadata that you want to share, or maybe there is a bunch of different images you want to add for your specific recipe instead of just having the one. This is how you're going to get that all together. So why don't we take a look at adding a recipe group for fields that will be relevant to all of our recipes. Okay, so to get started with our recipe field group, we're going to click on add new up here. We will call this recipe fields. There we go. And you're gonna have to generate a name for all of them, you know, as you would imagine. Now, let's explore this page a little bit. Up here, we've got, of course, the name. And then here, we're gonna have all the different fields that we'll be adding that we need for our recipes. Here is some conditional logic that you'll use on where these options are displayed and with what type of post it goes. But you can have all sorts of different options in here, as you can see, and you can set all different types of conditional logic. Is it equal or not equal to that? And just here are all of our custom post types, and right at the bottom, you'll see our recipe. There's other settings where you can activate or deactivate these field groups. And it just has style, it can have the positioning of it, it's got an order number, so if you have multiple field groups that go with a specific post type, which might be relevant, let's say if we wanted to collect a whole different set of metadata, That's where you would use that if you wanted that to be first instead of second. And then it just lets you hide all of the different attributes. You might remember all of these back from when we set the settings, when we created our custom post type with code. So that should look pretty familiar for you. But that is the lay of the land here. So why don't we take a look at adding some fields into this field group for recipe fields. Okay, so adding fields is just as easy as adding the group with a few different settings. So let's go ahead and add a field. We're gonna add the different ingredients, let's say, that will go into this recipe, and we're just gonna make it a preset list. So for field label, we'll say ingredients. And now another place this might work well is also for additional fields for pizza, let's say, or something like that for a restaurant. With that name that I put in the label, it'll generate the field name for me. And for this, these are all the different field types. Sorry, I almost went too fast. Here, you take a look at all the options that are available for you in the free version of Advanced Custom Fields. And you'll see that most of them actually are free of charge to use, which is fantastic. We're going to be using a checkbox because we want our users to be able to select various ingredients that are available. And this could be used to filter the post, all different sorts of settings. And just some of the pro ones to note here is the gallery, the repeater, flexible content, and clone. But other than that, you've got access to almost everything that you could want. So let's go ahead and select checkbox here. And you can add some instructions. So say, select all the ingredients for your recipe. There we go. We want that to be a required field because we want to make sure that the user puts that in. And now we get to all of the options. Now, in the real world, are you going to be sitting and typing in lettuce, beef, and all that? No. You'll probably find a list somewhere with all the ingredients that you want to facilitate on your site. You just paste them in here in lines, but we're not going to do that now. We'll slog it out with just a few different options that we can put in here. Let's say onion, garlic, can't eat something without garlic, pepper, olive oil. And I think that's good for now. Now, allow custom ones. So that is if you want the user to be able to enter their own. We're not going to do that for this example, but it could be a good way to make your database dynamic so that the options keep expanding, because here's the option to save custom ones to the database. But I'll leave it at this for now. And I'm not going to put in any default values. We want the user to do that. We can make the layout to be vertical or horizontal. That's a design choice. And then the toggle settings, the return values. Do you want to add conditional logic so that if they select something like ingredients in this field, you want to maybe make other things available on the page based on what they select? That's how you do that. We're not going to do that. It's a little bit out of the scope for what we're doing. Because Advanced Custom Fields is such a powerful plugin, it can be a little tricky to really get to know. But once you do, you'll build some really amazing things with it. But enough about that. We are going to go ahead and say add field. So this is going to add yet another field. So we've got our ingredients here. Okay, I'm just going to delete this for now. We'll just remove it. I'm going to scroll up and I'm going to publish this field group. Now we see that we've got ingredients in there, and now we can go ahead and say, okay, well, when the post type is equal to the recipe post type, we want to show this group of fields. So if I update that, let's see what happens if I go over here to recipes, open it up in a new tab, and edit the beefcake. And there you have it. You already have all the ingredients here now that is accessible to you on post creation, which is amazing. So for your recipes, you can have these in here. But you know, maybe we want to add that, you know, time to cook in there also. So why don't we go back over here to the field group and add another field, and we'll call it time to cook. We've got the label, it generates the field name for us. the type of field, this time we're going to use a range slider. And then we'll say slide to the amount of minutes it takes to cook your recipe. There we go. We'll make this also required. Default value will be 0. Minimum value will be 0. Maximum value will be, 240. Is that reasonable? And then step size will be 5 minutes. That makes sense to me. And then here we can prepend or append a word. I will add, append with minutes. We won't be using conditional logic here. And we can close the field. And we can see that our time to cook is there. Let's update. Hop back to our recipe. And there we have it. So now when I slide this over, it'll enter the amount of minutes it takes to cook. How awesome is that? So yeah, since this is the beefcake recipe, we'll say it takes carrot, beef, onion, garlic, pepper, and olive oil. Delish. Update that. And now your post is updated. It's got all that info saved in there. It's really awesome. So much quicker and more intuitive to use than the stock Divi way of doing it by adding at the bottom of the post that was there before we installed the advanced custom fields plugin. So, you know, as they say, work smarter, not harder. And this is definitely doing things a bit smarter. Okay, jumping back in here with the advanced custom field settings with our fields that we added in here, I want to mention just a few more things, you know, and another few ideas for you to think about as you embark on a journey getting to know advanced custom fields and using it with Divi. Now, another thing that you might want to add here, or maybe a field group you might want to create, if I click back here to field groups, could be maybe you want a field group for each step of your recipe. So within that, you would have maybe things like an image for the step. You might have a text block that describes the step to the user and so forth. And then you would have a group for each one of those steps so that when the user goes to the recipes field here or the custom post that you created and they edit it, they'll have step one and all the options that you want them to complete, step two, step three, step four, etc. Just another thing to think about when you are designing a site that's going to be using custom fields. And then just coming back in here to our recipe fields, we spoke a little bit about conditional logic and all the benefits that you can get from that. It's a really cool tool to use. Again, outside of the scope of this, but maybe you want, when there's an image in the recipe or one of the fields that's not completed, maybe you want to show a text description instead. You know, just little details like that that make the user experience a little bit better and stronger when building out their sites. Now, I looked into a few different types of field types here that are included, which is amazing. But I also just wanted to go ahead and come here into our recipe again and click on View Post to see what it looks like on the front end. And as you can see, this still has all the old data in there. Now, why is that? Well, it's because we haven't told Divi to go ahead and look for these new custom fields that are associated with this custom post type. Now, we're not going to cover that today. We're going to cover that in another video coming up here real soon. But in that video, we're going to look at some really interesting ways to go ahead and display your data. Like I told you before, we want to make these tutorials build on top of each other and not just focus on parrot work. It is really about understanding what I'm doing and having your brain start thinking how you can apply that to sites that you want to build. So there we have it. Guys, it was my pleasure to kind of get into the Advanced Custom Fields plugin. I know this was brief, but I think you know maybe a bit more about it than you did before and how easy it is to utilize on your Divi site and utilizing your custom post types that you create with whatever method you choose, be it with code or another plugin or whatever. But this was a nice little, you know, a little taste test of what's to come, of what we're going to be covering in this kind of theme series that we're doing with the Divi Engine team on Divi and advanced custom post types and advanced custom fields. So guys, that's it from me. This was Roby with the Divi Engine team. I'm gonna be catching you guys in the next video.